You gonna answer the question though? We're waiting on you.
Yeah. We're waiting on you. Next question, I'll come back to it.
Okay, the last show that I watched on Netflix, Big Mouth.
The last show I watched on Netflix is also Big Mouth because I'm on the fourth season and I told John David to get on it and he is now starting at the first season.
I mean, so, the question, they didn't ask all that. It's just
both watching Big Mouth thanks to me.
Thank you. Thank you. One sentence. We got to keep it moving. Come on. Depends on the show. Yes.
Depends on the show or yes?
Depends on the show, yeah.
Yes, I am absolutely a binge watcher. I will finish that shit in a night.
What do I watch when I want to laugh? Bill Burr, Mike Epps, Coming to America, some strong go-tos. Life, certain scenes of the movie Life.
Well, obviously Big Mouth because I've watched four seasons of it. I'm gonna also put in, like I said, the first 15 minutes of Superbad.
What do I watch when I want to cry? Maybe Up, or I still try to man up, but Glory gets me still. That's like one of my favorite movies.
To this day.
Yeah.
For me, I don't usually get emotional in movies, ever. I think there's been maybe two times I've cried during a movie before. It was just completely random and made no sense. I cried in a horror movie once. My niece was with me. Whenever she's with me, we get this like emotional connection thing and we just start crying. It had, I don't know. Oh. Actually, yes, the OA. I got to be in the OA because I was a huge fan and I asked to meet Britt and Zal because holy schmack. I've seen the first season like so many times, but there's a part where they do the movements and they bring one of the guys back to life and I get a little choked up every time.
Martin? I mean, I don't know if they got any Emmys. Like, where are the Emmys at? Best exhibition of storytelling and comedy of all times. Like, are you kidding? Yeah, Martin.
Dark. Nobody has, time I ask people about it, they haven't seen it and I have to put them on. And I'm like, yo, it's a German show, da da da. And I love that show.
I want to be in Sex and the City. Or Sopranos, maybe both. Do some guest spots on both.
Somebody already worked with Christopher Nolan, so he can't say that one, but I can.
I would have loved to work with like a Martin Scorsese. There's a grip of a lot of people I'd love to work with. That's not fair. There's a huge list of people that I'd love to work with, but just what comes to mind is a Scorsese. Paul Thomas Anderson.
All the greats. I would also love to work with Nia DaCosta. She just did Candyman, and I was actually gonna do something with her that didn't end up working out, but I think she's a brilliant young director, and I would love to work with her.
I learned what not to do in a relationship. I learned that his tactics and mine are not aligned. The spirit of what she's saying is I get. And his intentions, I get about 50% of them I can relate to maybe, but just whatever he does, just do the opposite, you know?
I think similar to what John David is saying, I learned definitely how to start an argument if you want one, and what are all the right things to say to crush somebody's ego. Yeah, I guess, I've learned definitely how I will not communicate with my partner.
Humble, fearless, brilliant.
There's so many words. There's not enough good words to describe John David Washington. Deeply kind, true. What you see is what you get. That is honestly who he is. Multifaceted. He can do so many things beautifully and execute them so well. And it's so cool to watch all the things that John David can do.